Yeah, so in light of the Oracle session I just did and the advice about, really now is the time, now that the chaos has started in the world, that now it's really, 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 if it wasn't ever before, it is now the time for all of us who are consciously on the spiritual path, particularly on the path to awakening or enlightenment, that it is really the time to hunker down and turn inwards, and to forgo trying to figure out what you're here to become in the world, because now's not the time. We need a lot more stabilization and presence and open vessels to bring in more light, to stabilize the light on this planet. Yeah, so this video perhaps is a good practice, or a good what am I trying to say? Sorry. Yeah, a good practice for all of us to do during this time, always and forever. Yeah, so I am going to be talking about Sat Chit Ananda. This is the Sanskrit term. Words come out of my mouth, please. That describes ultimate reality, right? But I do want to say, that book that I recommended you guys read, Liberation. I mean, I'm just so grateful to the universe and that book and the author for writing that book, because wow, it has been so comforting. I mean, I'm kind of shocked that everything he's saying in there confirms everything that I've said or said to myself or realized within myself. And thank God there's somebody out there who can put words to it. And it turns out, I realized this yesterday in thinking about Sat-Chit Ananda and what do those words mean? It means that Sat stands for existence or being. The Chit stands for consciousness or awareness. Or awakened consciousness or awareness. And Ananda means bliss. And those three words are the descriptors of ultimate reality, what we should, what is our true selves, our true essence, and what we're here to experience. So being, awareness, and bliss. And I realized yesterday, oh my God, I'm sure I'm not the only one that's ever realized this, but when you have the realization, you feel like, oh, I gotta tell people that this description is the recipe and the practice to become Sat Chit Ananda. I mean, it's all right there. And it turns out, I mean, duh. Duh, Kat, duh, Karen. I have been doing this and saying this, but for the last couple of years, when I was sharing in a couple of my personal shares, but most recently, I can't remember. I think it was the one where I said, I'm not suffering much. And I was talking about how when I breathe in the belly, I feel one thing, I experience that when I go up here, I experience one thing, and when I go to the heart, I feel another. Like, wow, that's when all the bliss kicks in. And I realized I have been doing Sat Chit Ananda, or as a practice. And I can recommend this for you as well. So if you look at Sat being meaning existence, or meaning our beingness, our ground of being, well, then you can equate that to the belly. And because our beingness is dependent on our breath, and the belly is kind of like our breath, our little cauldron of breathing. And if you and you can do this with your eyes open or closed, either way it is beautiful. But the first thing to do is just to, and this is all about turning inwards, right? Feeling yourself, becoming aware and conscious of yourself. So the first thing to do is just to tune in, to feel your own existence, to feel your own beingness, your aliveness. Yeah, you can feel that. You breathe into the belly and you can feel Yeah, I'm alive. I feel that vitality, right? And then the next step would be, and we're gonna would be, so that's sat, and then chit. What is chit? Well, chit is awareness, consciousness. So then we can go, yeah, I'm feeling my being, my aliveness. And now I'm aware. Not only am I aware of things out there, but what we really want to do is turn that awareness back on itself. Now we become aware that you're aware, being aware of awareness in this ground of beingness. So you feel your aliveness and you feel that you're aware, turning awareness back on itself, you. Now you're feeling ground of beingness. And you're aware of this beingness, right? And then suddenly you can drop into the heart, Ananda. And that's where you begin to feel the feeler. You can tune into the heart wherever that it's not really the heart. There is a little portal. And I've been for like 3 days, I've been trying to find this portal. It's there. It's there and it's not there. But it doesn't matter. You just kind of like shift to the heart. And the heart just is the feeler. It's so you begin to feel the feeler, kind of merging all those three, your ground of being, you're becoming aware, and then you turn it all in and start feeling the feeler. And I guarantee you, you're going to feel the bliss, the peace, the expansion, the warmth, the comfort of your true self. So the description, Sat Chit Ananda, is also the recipe and the practice to get you right back to to yourself. It's like, who needs any other practice? It's the ultimate practice of surrender. And absolutely, yes, someone's out there going to say, oh yeah, but there's a mind out there doing the practice. It doesn't matter. It will at least temporarily get you into the space of your true self. And that alone will be healing. It will spark, yes, it will spark things coming up, but at least you get to experience and feel your true self as bliss. Now, I just want to say that bliss is not ecstasy, is not rapture, is not, you know, your eyes rolling back into your head and this like, oh, bliss. No, bliss is it's more of a comforting, tingling, warm, expansive energy. You felt it before. And because it probably didn't blow your socks off or look like, you know, some saint in rapture, you didn't recognize it as bliss, but it's there. It's very subtle, but so delightful. So do that practice. And, yeah, it's all about turning everything back on itself. Sat, being, belly, chit, awareness, the head, your seat of consciousness, becoming aware. Yes, I'm aware of things out there, but now I'm becoming aware of the one who's aware. Okay. And then we fall into the heart, which is connected to the, you know, it's our human existence. Now we begin feeling the feeler. It's beautiful. Okay, so since chaos has hit the fan, it's time to do Sat Chit Ananda. Okay, bye.